Welcome back. You are joining me just in time for Operation Dark Rain. Thank you for coming. This is a council mission in Munich, Germany. I could tell you the description for this mission, but I don't know if you believe me. Essentially, the aliens are digging up dead bodies and abducting them. I mean, look, the aliens really need to step up at this point. The aliens have essentially gone, you know what? Abducting these live humans, this shit's hard. XCOM keeps killing us. They keep screaming, we haven't got enough green group to take them all home. This shit's hard, man. Fuck it. Let's just go abduct dead bodies. They're not going to put up a fight. And just like that, that is how you become an alien abductor who is just digging up dead bodies in Operation Dark Rain in Munich, Germany. We're going to touch down and we're going to see if we can stop these extraterrestrial necrophiles from fucking... Jesus, I can't believe I just brought necrophilia into this. Let's get down there before this briefing gets any worse.
The Council has intercepted a report indicating suspicious activity in some of the local cemeteries. Civilians have reported strange men in dark suits hanging around the area. They want us to find out what's going on.
And that's all it takes to get shot by XCOM, really. Just be wearing a suit. Just be wearing a suit and suddenly, you know, everybody's going to be looking out their windows calling 1-800-HOLY-SHIT. Or you can just call in, you know, fucking XCOM to come shoot it. What if it's just your neighbor? What if it's just your neighbor just hanging out in the graveyard wearing his dark suit? And you don't like your neighbor and you just take a picture of it. #aliens at XCOM #aliens. And you know, I'll just come send a raven over. Just drop a GBU on him. Just drop a bomb on him. No problem. I mean, where does it fucking end? I mean, what? I mean, you're just going to send us, like, go down to your Armani store. Send us a tweet. #got an alien abduction going on here. Oh, sure. We'll just come bring the Sky Ranger around. Just park it over the top. Drop the rappel lines. We'll just slide down the ropes into the Armani store. Just catch every well-dressed man in this horrible fucking free fire zone. That's fine. Tell you what's not free, though. Those bloody suits the thin men wear, those are fucking expensive. I mean, the aliens have got bank to have those, you know what I'm saying? Although I suppose getting those suits made for the thin men would have been a tall order. Sorry. No, I'm sorry. I couldn't resist. I don't want to do that too much here. I mean, this is a briefing. I don't want to unravel the thread of this discussion. It's stupid. Don't look at me like that. I'm sorry. It's just, you know, sometimes I just have a joke that is just tailor-made for the situation. I'll stop. It's supposed to be a briefing, and this is just... It's 100% unsuitable. I promise. No, I'm serious. I'm serious this time. That's the last one. We're gonna get into it now. I wouldn't want anybody in the comments to dress me down. No. We are gonna really have a real briefing. Here comes a real briefing. So, this map. So, if you go left here, as long as your alien enemies you're fighting can't jump like thin men, or they can't fly like floaters or chrysalids, you know what? A lot of aliens can jump. So this... You know, this only works if we run the mutons and mech, but we probably will. Point being, if we come along this left side, we make it so we can't be flanked from the left by anything we discover on the low ground. That makes things a little bit easier from a start. You've also got a lot of cover you can jump down to at any point. Like, the alternative would be jumping down straight away, but, you know, just leave it till you need to. So the idea here is we're going to run left along this this little burrow here. And if we hit contact... our support troops will take this priority cover at the back, which can't be flanked. The rest of our troops will jump down to the cover. We'll engage them. Pathfinder Daishi is here to help out. Mech Warrior Daishi is here to help out. And we're just going to clear out this first, sort of back of the map raised area. Once we've cleared out this whole back of the map raised area, it's just a shooting gallery for gamers to run between and snapshot. We'll probably push towards the central Malazium itself. Once we have the Malazium... we've got lots of good cover, lots of good concealment, and we can just use this as a literal bunker to just fire and control the rest of the map with explosives, rockets, whatnot. Our general strategy for firefighting here is using our grenades and our rockets to blow up the easily destructible cover. And apart from that, cleaning up once you've destroyed the cover with hit and run Daishi, taking a pair of shots, etc. Yeah, that's the general idea here. You should be clearing left, taking out cover, taking the Malazium, taking the map. Alright, players and player haters, let's get moving on this one. Where's my assault? Morgan, you're up front.
I'm rolling.
Nada. Nada, nada, nothing.
I'm rolling.
Kerkor, I'm up. It's kind of hard to select people. There we go.
Moving out.
Let's go, Daishi. Fantastic. Hunter. Game is ready. Ooh, we should probably get that Gauss machine gun ready, shouldn't we? We'll stick you right here so you can fire if you need to. You can use Daishi just in case you need to. But you really should have taken Jive's spot.
Overwatch. Moving to Overwatch.
Hopefully we get away with it. I'm gonna have that Gauss machine gun steadied as we get back into things here. Heavy floaters. Bane of my life. Okay. So, yeah, heavy floaters. Probably don't want to fight him in this terrain after all. Because if this is a heavy floater council mission, which it sounds like, then this elevation will simply work against me, I think. Oh, actually, you know what? I've got these trees on the left that I can take as well. It could still work out. It could still work out.
Headed there now.
And we still need to clear off this side of the map. Is the thing. Zim, with that in mind, why don't you head over here?
Look out!
Fairfox moving up. Gamage, you two are moving up.
Affirmativo.
Let's keep running along this side.
Heading there now. Double time.
Gotta watch that when the mouse flicks like that. You end up getting people going where you don't want them to go.
Got it covered.
And we're fantastic moving up. Go take a stroll in the rose bushes or whatever that is. The thistles, the violets, the irelias, whatever that is.
Yeah, I'll
fake. I feel, Commander.
Roger, I've moving got my to eye Overwatch.
Alright.
Shh. You hear that?
Towards that street lamp, towards that graveyard lamp that we got contact. What is this, an all heavy floater mission? This is Pathfinder. This is Mech's worst nightmare. Heavy floaters have a lot of heat ammo. And I can't hit and run them properly. So this is pretty much a nightmare for the Pathfinder.
I'm on the move. The Daishi. In sight.
There's a couple right now. 1, 2, 3, 4. Marvelous. Simply marvelous. I think that middle one Overwatch as well. No javelin on Payfork. And no one can see them. Well, that is interesting. I haven't really got a scout to run at either. We can, of course, use the ghost grenade if we need to here. It might end up being that the best way to get out of this situation is to ghost our way out of it. Because I've just got nobody you can actually see the fuckers straight up, which is really annoying. Who do I want to pop down into that position first? Not Jive. Probably our stalwart Grenadier Wutastic. Actually, she can grenade from up here. So then who do we drop down? Payfork's not snapshot. Probably Jive, you know, now that I think of it.
That's affirmative.
Give me some eyes on the situation here. So he didn't overwatch, and he is the big man. He's probably the one with heat ammo. Can't flamethrower him from this position. That's fine, we're just going to fall back. Hopefully not take too much fire, but if we do, that's why we bring the extra medkits on Hunter, is for the mech. Now, we'll bring across Morgan. If I run that Pathfinder out first, I can even move Morgan up to CCS this. Oh, that's a regular floater. Fuck him. I don't care about him. I want to shoot the big one. He's the threat. So I actually don't give a single shit about that one. That one's fine. Fuck that one. Fuck that one. This is the one I want to kill. Sorry. Now, with Snapshot, you could jump down Gamage and take some shots at all this. You could probably kill the little one for me, actually. Zim has got a target now, which is nice. Oh, you can see the big man. Okay, we need to get some... I don't think we have holo. But we need to get some shred onto that target. Now, I can't remember if Morgan's packing Shredder or Reinforced. I think it would have been Reinforced. Because I have a Rocketeer, that's usually how I do it. But we can shred both these cats. Nay problem. Nice and accurate. So why don't you go right there with a shred? Because that cat needs to die. I don't like that cat. Game's gonna have to jump down here. Probably finish off the little guy. Yep. Alright, now Zim. I am really just... It's just very unfortunate we don't have any holotarget on the squad, but... if you could hit 245s, you could make history as being the first person to not give a shit about heavy floaters. Oh my god, that tank sense. Fuck you. Go ahead and rapid fire it. That's a good start. Come on, baby. Ah, you did your best. You did your best. You did a good job. You could try. So that's a basic floater over here as well, so this actually pod isn't as bad as I first thought. So it's not so bad at all. And that one's gonna get sniped by Gamage. You probably just focus your efforts on killing this guy. Or missing him, as the case may be.
Adjusting sights.
Whatever you want, really. You're the star here. You decide how the party goes down. What do I want to do next then? What do I want to do next? I could potentially just stay here, I guess. Really need that guy to die, so I might take the shot with Gamage on him instead. Because the little baby floater, he's not so much a problem. He's pretty easily killed. It's this chap. This chap's the problem. Come on, Gamage. Oh, Gamage, you never let me down. Well done. You never let me down. Not even once. And now we can potentially just shoot his ass. Cold turkey. Cold-blooded. If I cross over right, he's pretty dead. Same with Hunter, though. If I cross over right with Hunter, he's also pretty dead.
In Bewegung. Contact.
I was wondering if there'd be contact on the right. So now I think we have another heavy floater on the right. Which we have to watch out for, of course. So this is where it gets more complex. Is now we've got a pod on the right. Now, how are we planning to deal with that? Well, Jive's kind of exposed from this current position. Jive is probably flankable by the majority of that pod. So a ghost here would be smart. So I can jump down and essentially... Ooh, I can't ghost both of them. So I'd have to run Wutastic back, jump down and just ghost in this little area right here. Okay, so Wutastic is going to have to come back.
Look out.
Hunter's going to pop down.
Heading to that location.
Morgan can come down here and shoot mans. Excuse me, you can come down here. You can come down here, Morgan. Excuse me. Alright, fine. Now to run out here. That's fine then, I guess. What's the range? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Yeah, it's fine. You can run down here. That's okay. In fact... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. It's right on the cusp. I wouldn't try that. I was going to see if I get my 3 CCS on it to get a more accurate shot, but there shouldn't be any need. So we're running here.
Moving out.
We'll shoot that man. That man's dead.
X-ray neutralized.
We have 2 floaters on the left. I can't remember if one of them's heavy. Then we got 4 more floaters on the right. So we got to watch that. Daishi can probably just engage this fucko. Because he ain't heavy. He ain't dead either. It's unexpected, but still. Now we'll go ahead and ghost all of us. And as you can see, there is, you know, going along this way, there is a lot of this crossfire potential because of the way that this cover is all one-directional. It's very annoying the way that works. But that's the map.
Hostiles are losing ground.
Like, if I wasn't running ghost grenades, I want to be a bit safer. I wouldn't have gone right, because you can generally expect contact to be in that direction. That's why I wanted to test the waters with Wutastic first, just to see. Looks like we've got 2 basic floaters on the left, so it doesn't bother me much at all. It's the heavies that are the problem, and here comes the heavy. And thank God he's a moron. There's nothing better than moronic heavy floaters, because they're so scared. What the fuck are you idiots doing? Is there a meme beacon there I can't see? What are you doing? You're just begging for it. Join your friends. Oh, they're just begging for it. Why is this happening? I don't know, but I'm gonna take advantage of it. Let you run over here.
Moving to position.
Is there something they know that I don't? Like, what's going on here? Oh, I'm being baited. Is that what they know that I don't? Clever, clever. I'm being baited into this amazing move. Because I'm being baited. It all makes sense now. Alright, well, we're gonna murder this little pod while we start to think about dealing with the bigger pod. The bigger picture here. Engage him to start. That's hit and run, he's almost dead. Man, that health really ain't shit when you get down to it, is it? I keep having to remember that. Now, I could flame and probably just destroy this entire pod. Or I could ghost a Pathfinder and move on to probably also totally fuck this pod later. Like, in a second, I can flame them in a second. Which is probably good, and then I won't get team baited again. Won't get fooled again. And that'll work out if I can ghost everyone right here. If I can just run up, you know, take a couple of shots and then just ghost everyone again. Use my other ghost. Look, I can move to the right side of that bench. Not a problem. Get CCS and ghost. Run the Pathfinder up. Probably run the assault up as well. Oh no, the assault's got closer combat specialist. Don't do that. But we can move them to the right here. As long as I'm not going to get caught by that overwatch. Hopefully I won't. Zim has got target on only one floater, but we might just reposition her instead. So we bring Morgan around the right.
Moving.
Okay, hello. Now we're gonna probably sit here and take two shots with Ghost. What's Wutastic gonna do? Well, apparently if I hit off the bench, I can hit all of them. That's interesting. No, just a few of them. But the other one will be dead anyway. Probably kill the heavy floater with this. Saves me a shot on the heavy floater. Or I could just run up and start grenading those idiots. Run up and start. Now, is Jive going to be safe there? Jive should be safe from a flank there, I think. So Jive can take two accurate shots from this position. And we'll just check that that grenade is good. It is. It's up and it's good. Okay. Go ahead and see then if we can save ourselves a shot on heavy floater and also deal some cursory damage to these morons. Throw a little grenade right there. Save us a shot. Good. Bang. And bang. Bang. Oh, bang. Now I can move up and ghost you as well. That's excellent. Maybe I could ghost all of you. We should prep another rocket off Pavehawk. Would be nice. Which I think means I should move her up to here. Then she's ready to rocket him next turn.
Facciamolo.
Facciamo. She's ready. Kinda means Jive isn't. Oh, Jive can move up to there, that's fine. Well, it should be okay anyway.
Heading to that location.
We're exploiting Ghost to the max right now. Let's move up to the right. Should be able to get some shots from here, hopefully. I have a shot. I have a single shot. We'll hunker you. And then what are you gonna do, Gamage? What you gonna slam for Christmas? Why don't you slam... Ooh, we haven't got lock and load yet, and this is your only shot. Why don't you just go ahead and deal some damage to him, because we need damage dealt to him. You're gonna miss, aren't you? Oh, wow, no. Even though I think Gamage is gonna miss, Gamage never lets me down. And you back up a little bit. Ghost all these folks, all these fine folks right here. Zippy zoom. And we can be way more aggressive when we've got the ghost backing us up like that, because now I can move up with Daishi. We can go scatter a bunch of bullshit, and we can go get ready to flame on. Moving. So, holla holla. Heavy Flitter's running. No, he's back. He's back. He couldn't decide. Oh, the pod might have just teleported? Is that what happened? Man, weird shit happens when you ghost people. Look, like, when the aliens are out of line of sight, I think they just do what they want. But I think the game treats them as being out of line of sight when you're ghosted and you're looking at them, so you get this weird thing that I've never seen before now that I've started using stuff like ghost grenades and concealment in Beta 15, where they do really weird shit. And in fact, I think what's broken about stealth, really, which is a shame, isn't so much the stealth itself. The stealth itself is fine. They could overwatch and react to it properly. The problem is the AI just does not seem to be... Like, the AI seems to have this fatal error in its programming where it actually goes insane when you ghost something. Like, it just seems to go nuts. I don't understand. Anyway, please tell me you can see the big boss now. Nah, you can't. Oh, well. If enough of you can see the heavy floater, we can commit. Oh, some of you really can't, huh? You can. I think we can take it out. I'm going to send in a regular rocket here, actually. I'm going to use a regular rocket on these varmints. This is my rocket quest. To kill all the floaters. To train them is my cause. Pokemon. Oh, you're my best friend. Okay, move to the left. Loaded. Now that's 100% on that floater, so he's pretty much dead. Then hopefully this one's dead as well. Daishi can also hit and run that one for total freebies. But I think, wasn't there another one around here that I can hit and run for freebies as well? Where is he? I forgot where he went. I'm just trying to look for him. I think that's him right there? I don't know. There was another freebies around here, I thought, and I could hit and run him instead. We'll find out with Morgan, I think. Morgan's going to want to run up and engage that heavy floater at close range, I think. It's going to be the wise move. We're going to go balls to the wall, all's in. In fact, if I move up with Morgan...
I'm rolling.
There he is. There's the other one. He's over there. And we're going to push it to the limit here. We're going to walk along that razor's edge. I won't look down. I'll keep my head or I'll be finished. Oh, I didn't see him. That's a shame. Hit and run would have been good there. But regardless, what was more important is I wanted good positioning for this flamethrower. Because this is going to solve some problems. And you know what? These guys aren't even really that big a problem right now. The ghost grenade made him kind of just spaz out. It's more that I just love burning. Burning is good. If you don't like burning, you're just lying to yourself, I think. I think everyone likes burning a little bit.
Call ass. I'm on the move.
Hello? You still can't see that one, huh? Alright, well, I'll take care of it for you. Should take the LMG shot first, though. Oh, wait, you're not double tap, you're rapid fire. My mistake. I was gonna go bop bop, thinking all LMGs have double tap, but of course, that's not at all true. It's not even close to true. That's fine.
Nailed him.
Chad's cleaning him up.
He's down.
Morgan's throwing him out the back.
Kill confirmed.
Running dry.
Right, I think we're just down a big old heavy floater who's panicking like a crazy man right now.
They don't have eggs.
Show them what you think of that. Okay. It's always hard to kill heavy floaters, even when they're panicked. It's never easy to kill a heavy floater. Doesn't matter what's happening. It's always a pain in the ass. Good job, Hunter. What the hell? He was like hanging onto the roof like, no, please. No. I don't want to go to school. Well, we've taken the Malazir and we've just also blown it up a lot. So, you know. Pluses and minuses.
On the move. Contact.
Ooh, chrysalids. That's weird. Two heavy floaters and two chrysalids. That is interesting. Fuck you. Leave me alone. Leave me alone. Please. Please leave me alone. Oh, I can go on the roof, hey. Interesting. Maybe I'll do that. Maybe I won't. Let's see. What I can probably do here is move to like this position. Oh, I don't know. Where do I want to move to? We need to get suppression if we can or something to deal with those heavy flots. Or yes, even blow them up with a grenade. Even blow them up with a grenade would be good too.
They don't have eggs.
Then we can hit and run them. We can try to take them out. It's gonna be all gravy. We can take out one of these heavy flots, the Pathfinder. Daishi can just do whatever she wants. The problem is right now, if we haven't got either of the heavy flots dealt with, it's an issue. If I could get the Gauss long rifle in position as well, that would be ideal.
Mi muovo.
Mi muovo, mua. Deal some big damage there for me, I think. Good damage. Don't have the range on that rocket just as yet, unfortunately, but that's alright for right now. Hang on. Now, what am I going to do about this? I can potentially laser pistol this one. But I need to kill these chrysalids, so we'll have to see who can move up here to kill these chrysalids. Maybe you? Oh yes you can. Potentially. Ah! Forget about it. Forget about it! Zim needs to move up. Zim hasn't really got many good places to move up to. If I go... hit and run, and then flame, that could work out nicely. Could also work out to my death. It'd be much nicer to be able to go hit and run, then flame, because then that heavy float is probably dead. But it still leaves me of having to deal with this chrysalid on the left somehow. Maybe what I could do here.
Moving.
Maybe Hunter can solve this for me, please. Please, Hunter. That would be so good if you could hit this 62. That's why he misses, because it would have been good if he could have.
Negative damage.
I don't know what to tell you, man. These chrysalids need to die for my master plan to work. So we're going in. We're going hard. Don't call me Shirley.
Burning through ammo fast.
Dead and gone.
You know it is. You know what it is. Now even more because I've got Jaya flapping out in the wind here. Obviously we have to go hard. But that's the plan. That's what we're doing. We're going hard. Hit and run, baby! Blow up that cover, take him out. That was the plan, that's what's happening. Get fucked!
Firing incendiary.
Alright, let's move up the Venerable Zim. The Venerable Zim Nort.
Unterwegs.
Get it ready. So hopefully that heavy float is just gonna tangle with that mech. Otherwise, I don't think he moved far enough to hit my exposed troops anyway. What's your plan, baby? What are you doing? You grenading? Alright.
No major damage.
Approaching damage threshold.
Oh no, one damage. I just painted this! That's okay, we'll be okay. I'll manage. I'll get through this somehow.
On my way.
With a little bit of help from my friend's science-spiration, I think.
Moving.
Alright, give it to him. I waited till I moved the assault up because I want to get science inspiration on both of them. May as well.
I give you strength.
Hey, Daishi's back in the game. Although, unfortunately, Daishi's only have a yellow move. She can't do a whole lot. But hey, she's back in the game. Probably go ahead and reload Morgan. I think I can get a flank with Wutastic.
In Bewegung.
Yep. Say hello to the flank, mate. Open up the flank clutch. Okay. Nah, it's alright. That's alright. Didn't want to do shit. I think what I'll do is go ahead and flush him. Get him the back off a bit.
I have no ammunition.
Reload that alloy cannon. And now we need to get our heavy hitters into position here. So here comes Jive.
On the move.
Here comes Zim.
Look out.
Here comes Pavork. They're all coming. And here comes Gamage. Now let's see what he does. Well, these loaders are not to be fucked with, but I think we're handling him as best as we can. And I think he's making some errors in his own tactical judgment right now. We're out of ammo on Daishi, but that's okay. This guy's pretty much fucked.
Heading to that location.
Hello and goodbye. Oh, I'm sorry, maybe you didn't hear me. Welcome to the graveyard.
Another one down.
Nice and easy. Not too hard. Mainly thanks to the floaters just being dumb as hell in those like two turns when we popped the stealth. The floaters just seemed to do whatever the hell they wanted. They're just like, you know what? We don't know where the ghost is, but we're frankly scared and we're not going to overwatch. We're just going to teleport backwards and then move back to where we started. So, yeah, I don't know why the AI does that with stealth. It's a little bit weird. But regardless, let's be a little more aggressive. We clean these floaters up, no problem.
A flawless effort, not a single casualty.
Thank you. Corpses. A little bit of Illyrium and alloys. Who would have thought we need to be protecting corpses? No, you're right.
Remember, we will be watching.
How strange. So now the Mech 2 Defender can roll back onto the production line. And onwards we go, really. I think I'll be able to do a fist if I want. I've got enough alloys for it. Fists are really good. Fists are great. I could also build a secondary proxy mine launcher if I wanted to go on Renzol, but in two mech lineups, Renzol is rarely going to be the Mech 2 until that Mech 2 is complete, so I've got a week left to worry about that, I think. Well, the other mech will be done in a week. What would do more good for me right now, a fist or a mine launcher? Well, I haven't got the close combat upgrade for the fist yet, so its value is somewhat limited until I can get that. So it's probably better to just go for the second proxy mine launcher and just spam mines. And then worry about other stuff beyond that. Or, is there any foundry approach I can get? No, they're all a little bit too expensive. So I'll probably get to work on a secondary proxy mine launcher to be ready when the Mech 2 is ready, and then our archers are going to have a good amount of mines, a good solid amount of mines for every mission, and that's going to be really fun. I'm going to really enjoy that. Apart from that... Yep, our slots are all full. Let's carry on. Hey! Straight up, baby. Chikoroi is straight up a psychic babe. No problem about it. So that was her first run of psychicisms, right? Yeah, straight up. No probs. Chikoroi, neural feedback, forget about it. You try to get in Chikoroi's head? Nah. Nah. She's gonna kick you out with that neural feedback. Doesn't take a telepath to know what you're thinking, alright? You just stay the fuck out. Chikoroi's not having none of it. Now, who else can I psychic up here? This is Jimmy. W. I was thinking about StarCraft quotes, not thinking enough about Psychic. So inspiration. There you go. It's like one of my favorite lines. This is Jimmy. Okay. So the first of our Valkyries. And, well, all of our mechs. Our first two Valkyries and our Shogun is ready. But before we get into that, it's time to add some more people to the production line, dare I say it. As it kind of is. Now, I believe I was doing Payfork and J-Bells, because as we get that second mech 2 online, we're really running out of the need of regular Rocketeers. We more need Archers. I need more Archers to fill out those missions. So, Payfork and J-Bells on the Arching is going to be good. Organ can stay as our one organic Rocketeer, basically. And I think that's the next thing. So, we'll pop them in if we've got the resources for them, which I believe we should. Alright, Diesel, you knew this day was coming ever since we started calling you Diesel.
Once the required amputations have been completed, the engineering team will begin grafting the cybersuit interfaces onto the volunteer's remaining bone structure.
And Karakorum Payfork is also joining
Understood,
the robots.
Commander. We'll begin fitting the cybersuit interface modules as soon as the necessary limbs have been
now,
removed.
Now, I don't have enough meld to make another mech anyway, so I can't right now anyway, but I'm not sure if there's any more mechs I want to build right now. That's going to be... two Valkyries. I think a third Valkyrie potentially is what I would like. As I look imposingly down at what infantry are left to Valkyrie. But I don't know. Jive is doing pretty well as an organic infantry as well. So it could probably be like two Valkyries. You've still got your Shogun in there. You've still got your Pathfinder and your Marauder. I could think about a Goliath in the future at some point for like base assaults and stuff, because they really do tank hard of a Vengeance. We'll think about it in the future. Maybe, actually, Panzerskank could be my Goliath, because I don't have time to train her to be anything else, and my god, like, with a name like that, like, what the hell do you expect? So maybe Panzerskank can become my Goliath. My very, very low-level Goliath. Goliaths are pretty good from the start, because they start with Absorption Field, so it's not too bad at Goliaths. They're probably one of the few classes I wouldn't mind meching at a very young rank. Apart from that, though, I think we're going to hold on. I think all my other gunners are... good at doing what they're doing. I want to keep them in those roles. Okay, so we better gear these people up, hadn't we? Now, I shouldn't have to refer to anything to fill out these trees. Shogun's going to go with... probably with an arch. They're like an alternative frontline tank, so... you're going to go like, body shield... what do we want here? Heat Warheads is ridiculous because you're going to work them with an Archer anyway, and they haven't got the grenade perks to be good with explosives anyway, so you're going to go with Shock Absorbent Armor here. Because they are kind of main tanking for you. You miss out on Repair Servos, which is a shame. It's a shame because Repair Servos is part of tanking. But out of the three defensive perks, the big trio of Repair, Damage Control, and Absorption Field, I say Repair Servos is the weakest of the three. So, it's good that you can afford to pick up heat ammo here, and that's really what the Shogun is to me, is they're a light-em-up heat ammo tank. Now we get down to here, again, I'm not really taking mines or grenades on my Shoguns. This would be useful for flamethrowers, and it would give you, like, one more flame, but apart from that, damage control is an incredibly strong perk for, well, taking damage. And you get down to here, Gunnery Sergeant, it's Grenadier, Vital Points, and light-em-up. You know what, I mean, you could go Grenadier, Packmaster, Sapper Heat Warheads, and you know what? Your Shogun will actually have better cover destruction than an Archer, which is useful if you're using the grenade launcher, but I don't think the mine ever really cares about environmental destruction. I think the mine just kills everything because it's like a satchel charge with a remote sensor on it. And you would miss out on a lot of good perks, I think, and you wouldn't have Bombardier. But, you know, there's an alternative idea for an Archer, I guess. You could build a Shogun and try and do it, but correct me if I'm wrong, I don't think you get Mayhem on the Shogun either, so Mayhem's a lot of the damage as well. Anyway, the point is, the choice then is really between VPT and light 'em up. Look, I mean, do you want to shoot once more per turn? Do you want to shoot for two more damage per turn? Or do you want to shoot twice a turn? Or shoot and absorption fields? Or shoot and flame? Like, shoot to different targets. It's just, I don't know why VPT is against light 'em up. It's just really a fucking no-brainer here. It's got to be light 'em up. And that's really what the Shogun is good at, is you get absorption fields as a Master Sergeant. And the Shogun is good at Beta 14. This isn't in Beta 15 anymore. They changed it, everything in Beta 15. But in Beta 14, your Shoguns are like these off-tank anti-tankers. They get heat ammo, they get light ammo, and they're your off-tank anti-tank mechs. They will take the hits, and they will dish that damage back out. The Sector Pods, Mectoids, Seeker Pods. Oh man, Collateral plus Heat is... It works. You do like 7 damage to everything in the blast. It's just stupid. So Petite is ready. Now we go into the Valkyries. Now the Valkyrie is similar but different. You have light them up from the start. What do we want here? Again, platform stab doesn't combo with light them up as well as you'd think, because it's only on the first shot. You do not get this bonus on your second shots, because once you shoot, you lose platform stab. So if you want a plus 10 and a plus 10 crit on your first shot only, sure. I don't really like my Valkyries as sit-still light-em-uppers as much. Light-em-up's good as a bonus, but I mainly like them for the rapid fire. They're like my... In Beta 14, that is. They're your shock troops in Beta 14, I think. They're your shock mechs. You're not gonna be overwatching. So Body Shield's your defensive pick. Body Shield is very good. It's like a poor man's resilience, and it also makes them considerably less likely to be hit, which is quite handy when they're out in the open doing nothing useful. Here we've got Damage Control, Jet Boot Module, or Advanced Fire Control. Now, Jet Boot is really good, and Jet Boot is really good. It's good for keeping your squad, or keeping your mechs with the squad once you get Grapply Armor and Archangel all the time. It can be annoying not being able to Jet Boot your mechs up. It's good for, you know, taking elevation bonuses, but ultimately, you know, maps are... There's a lot of high ground you can exploit in maps, but it's not all about roofs. A lot of maps are just, like, flat-out engagements. Whereas Damage Control, if the Valkyrie is going to be my tank, Damage Control, like I said, is very important. We have got the pick here between Shock Absorbent, Ranger, and Shredder. Now, Shock Absorbent obviously is a straight tanking perk, but I don't think I need to worry about going full tank on the Valkyrie. They can be an off tank, because Shredder is a huge pickup, especially when you're not running the Pathfinder and you're running an Archer. You have no other source of Shredder on your team unless you brought the Shredder item on your Assault, and that slot is better taken up with Reinforced Armor or a Mind Shield or something. Shredder ammo is amazing. Shredder ammo is... You can shred 2 different targets a turn of your Valkyrie. That's really cool. So that's why I call the Valkyries in Beta 14, I call them my Shredder tanks. Down here, you got another hard choice here. It is basically Collateral, Reactive, or Repair. Now, Reactive can get just put out of this race at the start, because you're not building for Overwatch, you didn't take Advanced Fire Control, and I think Reactive still suffers from penalties because it's a reaction shot, I'm pretty sure. So the choice is between Collateral and Repair Servos. Now, it's what you need to be done. Like I said, Repair Servos is probably the weakest of the three. And Collateral is a very strong perk because it's infinite. It's infinite. As long as you have ammo, you can use this based on its cooldown. It's a very strong perk. But I don't believe Collateral applies Shredder. That's one of the big synergies gone out the window. I'm pretty sure we tested this and Collateral does not apply Shredder. If Collateral applied Shredder, this would be more of a race. The other thing is, you got to consider the squad you're operating in. Now, the squad you're operating in is going to have grenades from your engineer, probably. Or you might have a support engineer, so maybe. But you're going to be operating with an archer most of the time. And Collateral doesn't set off mines, usually. And your archer, most of the time, is going to have all the cover destruction in the world you need. And once you get to late game, cover destruction is less of an issue, because you've got things like floaters, you got things like mech, you got things like berserkers, and ethereals, and none of them care about cover. So Collateral is still useful, but less so in the late game. Whereas Repair Servos, if I need my mech to be tanking and my squad already has other cover destruction options, like mines, like grenades, then Repair Servos is a no-brainer here, because that Collateral damage, that's going to be redundant. It's going to be useful, don't get me wrong. It would be great to have it, but it's going to be redundant compared to... I'm going to need this Valkyrie to be my tank, you know, this is my off-tank Valk. I need this to be, you know, aping a Goliath, pretending it's a Goliath. So, I'm going to pick up Repair Servos there, because it's going to be taking the hits for me. And again, lock and load. I don't know if it was in Beta 14, I know in Beta 15 this perk actually works, apparently. I know it didn't used to, but now apparently it does let you load and then shoot. Whereas in previous betas, I'm pretty sure it just gave mechs more ammo. You've also got VPT. Which is going to be really good for more damage, obviously. But again, tanking. This is my frontline shock troop. It's going to be absorption fields. And then once you get down to the bottom, I forget what the other choices are, but it's going to be rapid fire for me, because I want these guys to be shock troops. These are the mechs who move up rapid fire, and you're just moving up, and you're lighting shit up, and you're just tanking hard. So Merlin is ready for action, and we'll leave Volatile for right now. Okay, so I guess we can carry on here. I suppose. There's that mech 2 ready. You better believe it. Makes me happy. Is there anything else I can build while I'm waiting for the other mech 2 to complete here? Not so you'd notice. No, not really so you'd notice, I don't think. We'll leave it running. Okay, you want my drone wrecks? You can't have them. How about that? Now, I think I have some satellites put up before the end of the month as well, don't I? I've got 2 satellites now, and I'm probably going to put one up over India and one up over Australia to prep for a base assault soonish on Australia, and also to, you know, take, hopefully, save India. We'll travel a little bit further. Okay. Let's launch those sats. We'll probably just go ahead and put one up over India right now.
Satellite launched.
And, you know, maybe we'll just hang on to the other one. You know what? I could just build another satellite. I've got room for 2. It's just a case of if I want to throw another one up. I got $114 to build a satellite. Is there anywhere I would want to put a satellite up right now? I mean, I can get a free engineer, I can get free money. I'm not going to get any benefit from putting that one up over Australia just yet. I could put one up over Germany and just get a lot of dollars this month. That's going to pay for the satellite just in itself, even if it doesn't get, you know, even if it gets shot down, that pays for the satellite. Plus, I get an extra scientist. Plus, it might draw some UFO activity over to Europe away from my other air game. Unsuccessful trials of human cybernetic implants in the United Kingdom raise questions of plausibility. Huh. What's that about? Heavy casualties in Brazil as poorly equipped government forces.
We're currently tracking several unidentified
aliens.
Targets,
what?
Nothing that requires our attention just yet.
Is this like if I ignore council requests that happens? That's very guilty. It makes me feel very guilty. But yeah, I can just make my money back off a sat to Germany. So we may as well just put a sat in Germany. Unless there's any requests. No? Let's just put a free sat in Germany. I don't have a skeleton key building, do I? I'm not that crazy, am I? No? We've got time to build another satellite for the next base assault. Let's just get some free money.
Satellite launch.
Hey Germany, we're covering you. Psych. Advanced power armor is complete. I wish I had the alloys to start building this stuff. We got a mech 3 ready for manufacture if I had the resources for it. And you can see why I want to hit those base assaults real soon, as soon as I can handle them, and I think it's going to be my mech 2 timing, because, you know, once I've got the resources rolling in from those base assaults, oh boy, we are in a whole new age. We've got mech 3 paladins coming, we've got titan armor coming, and that means we've got archangel armor coming right after it. And that is really exciting, because we are just diving headfirst into the new year with good technology. This stuff is great. This stuff is my bread and butter for late game. I'm going to love it. Now, I don't have enough allies to do anything else, so I may as well just go ahead and do a heavy floater autopsy.
Another variation on a previously identified specimen, this is the heavy floater. As you can see, the aliens have made substantial improvements to the armor and weapons systems available, while removing some of its exposed vulnerabilities. An extremely dangerous combatant.
And he looks cool. You forgot to mention that, Valen. He looks gnarly. Let's look at what we're going to need to make in resources to build those new equipment. So, here's your Corsair armor. Now, Corsair isn't actually that bad. The cost is still prohibitive. You know, you're paying mech costs for this, essentially. But it's 20 Illyrium and 30 alloys, right? 20 Illyrium and 30 alloys. But you're getting grapple, you're getting medium armor for 6 health bonus, that's not so bad at all. Plus you're getting plus your mobility, plus the defense. It's not a bad armor at all for people who need to move fast. But it still is a bit on the squishy side. Enter the Titan armor. Now the Titan, you see it takes less Illyrium but a little bit more alloys. It's more of a brute force approach. But it's the same price. Now this is going to give you 10 health. Alright, straight up, just 10 health coming at you. It's It's going to give you a sealed internal air supply, hermetically sealed. You have got immunity to gas, immunity to, well, partial immunity to gas. The acid will still affect your armor, but you've got immunity to the damaging aspects of gas, like you've got a med kit. You cannot be strangled anymore. You have got immunity to fire. You can move through fire with the flame resistance. There's like air conditioning in it. It's pretty insane. It's pretty awesome armor. Like, I put a lot of stock in being tough enough to wear, you know, to wear some alien grenade damage or, you know, an unlucky hit. And Titan armor is beautiful. The other reason I put all my stock in Titan armor is because it develops later into Archangel. Like, right off the bat, this armor is very slow. Your troops are very fat in Titan armor. They do not have any mobility bonuses at all. It can be quite difficult unless you take the Walker servos. But once you get to Archangel armor, you're going to upgrade your Titan armor suits into Archangel. It's very expensive, but then everybody can fly. And forget about it, you can fly now. Finally, we've got the Mech 3 Paladin. This thing costs an absolute truckload of resources. We could probably knock over an alien base and only come out with enough to build one of these. Regardless, it's going to cost you 60 meld, 80 alloys, 40 illyrium, and $500, and you're going to have to put one of your Mech 2s out for a week once again. But this thing is the pinnacle. You're going to get another, I think it's 8, or is it another 4 health? You're up to 18 health on your Mech 3s. You have slots for 3 secondary subsystems, so that means you could take an Electropulse module, a Kinetic Strike module, and a Flamethrower. This thing is just fucking awesome. I'm pretty sure it has more inbuilt DR. I could be wrong about that, but it's just pretty awesome. And we're going to want to get our Mech 2s up to Mech 3. So you're just getting an extra 4 bonus, but also, the other thing to keep in mind is it's not just the health bonus written on the tin. The better your technology level of your armor, the better extra conditioning will help you. Now, mechs don't get extra conditioning, Beagle. No, that's not true. Alloy Belt gives them extra conditioning in Beta 14. I'm not sure if it does in Beta 15, but it does in Beta 14, definitely. So you're going to get even more of a health boost off your Mech 3, off Alloy Belted troops. So basically, yeah, we just unlocked 3 really cool things, and we're going to want to get onto them as soon as we can, and that means it's going to be time for a base assault very soon, and we are going to move towards taking the initiative, taking the aggression, putting the knife in the aliens as opposed to them putting it at us all this time. We're finally approaching the turning point where it's a new year and we start saying, hey, fuck you, we're gonna start running this war now. Unless I fuck up and lose, you know, that's always possible. That's enough blabbering from me. Let's move on for right now.
Incoming transmission.
Excellent work, Commander.
Excellent.
This council is pleased to see our continued support of this project has been worthwhile.
Wonderful.
We hope that your current successes only mark the beginning of an enduring effort to eliminate the extraterrestrial threat. We will be in touch, Commander.
Alright, now it is... let me just get this here. It's Happy New Year. It is a whole new year. I imagine around the base, everybody's partying. Well, the game doesn't really show that. It really just shows that everybody's just... Man... You guys never even party? I must have missed a party. They didn't even invite me to the parties. But everyone's back to business as usual, I guess. I guess the party happened while I wasn't looking. Here you have, is that Merlin, I think? Merlin proving that her organs are still real, even if her limbs aren't. Doing some shots. Everybody. Some peeps over here. That looks like, is that Squid? I don't know who that is. I'm not very good at... Because people wear hats and stuff, so they get like random hairstyles. I'm not very good at picking people out once I get there. Down here. Someone back there just contemplating the meaning of life. Are you a robot? No, you're just wearing the Gmod armor. You must be one of my people in psychic testing or something. Regardless, there's less partying going on than I expected. Bradford didn't keep me in the loop on that. But we, I guess what they know, what I know... is we still have a lot of work left to do. Varad, goddammit! Varad snuck out of the Psylabs for the New Year's party. I think that's what happened. Alright, well, you know what, Varad? You're gonna go back in the tube. Ooh! Hypergeek! Yes! Oh, I can't get mind merged yet. You shitting me? That kind of hamstrings my continued development of Hypergeek. What is that? Like, Sectoid Commander Interrogation? What is that? I'll have to look that up. Regardless, I want to put Mind Merge on him, I think, not Psypanic, so we'll wait on him. You, on the other hand, DSM, you can go straight into Psypanic. That's totally fine. carry on. Kung Tut also snuck out to the party. Are you kidding me? Guys, come on! What is it with my snipers and not being able to hit their psychic chances? Shoot. Shooting patooties, big buggy baby bumpers. Diggy dang it. Ah, pooty patootie, I can't mind merge Hunter either. Get back in the tube, I guess, Kung Tut. Get back in the tube with that Psy-inspiration. Yes, please, I've been waiting for you to take these, like, forever. Please, Egypt, take my live sectoid. Let's hope the Egyptian military can keep it contained. We just, like, give the trade, we just, like... He's, like, we got, like, got him just holding his hand. He's got, an orangutan diaper on, like, people who have the trained monkeys. Just, like, luring him out. He's, like, gaping around like an orangutan. We just, like, hand him over, like, push him towards the Egyptians at the border. Like, okay, here you go, Gleep Bloop. Go to your new parents. Scree! 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 He, like, runs over. The Egyptian military is like, what do we do with it? It's like, just change its diaper. Just bathe it, feed it, raise it with proper values. You know, whatever you want to do with it, really. Put it in movies. It's time for the heavy flood autopsy to be done. Alloy carbide plating is now available, as is advanced repair. Both of those are things we want. This is more damage resistance for our mechs. This is faster repair times for our interceptors, faster repair times for our mechs. Now, obviously, that's a double good. I don't think mechs really care about repair time that much anymore. It's not beta 15 where they do care about repair. But what is really important here is getting the air game back on track with advanced repair. That'll be really handy. Hey, I can interrogate a heavy floater. Let's do it. Ugh, how horrible was that? You see him draw his nails down the glass. Ugh, how inhumane. I also see I haven't done Sector Commando Autopsy yet. Man, I haven't fought one of these guys where I've blown all their corpses up. I suspect that's why I can't mind merge. I suspect that's what I need.
Arrived this morning, Commander. We're always glad to have more help down here.
They arrived this morning, Shin? This particular morning? Interesting. What else do I... I've got some money here. I should probably be buying some stuff. I just haven't got money alloy that just kept scanning because I'm like, I haven't got alloys, can't do nothing. Well, I can't build anything just yet because we're still waiting for power, so we can wait on that. No alloys to really do that much fun down here. Advanced repair is in my grasp. If I get a few more alloys, I can actually get advanced repair, so that'll be very, very good. We're going to work on that. Apart from that, I don't think there's anything pressing I want to build. Maybe some more interceptors soonish. But again, it all costs alloys. I'm kind of happy to just run kind of skint on my interceptor game right now. Probably build a couple of spare satellites, just get them going. I can always cancel them if I don't need them. May as well have them building, you know. Because I did put that kamikaze satellite over Germany. Whoa, Nelly, what are you doing? Check it out, Leonard Skinner. Find out what this is. Is this a shipment of alloys for me, or is this a terror ship?
We lost the bubble.
Please be a shipment of alloys. That looks like a shipment of alloys, unless it's an abductor. Please be a shipment of alloys. I need alloys. Ah, it's an abductor.
Commander, we have multiple reports of new abductions in progress. The locations are marked on the hologlobe.
All right. Well, it's the first of the new year. Light abduction in Edmonton, Canada. Now, I suspect most of my troops are good to go here. We could wait for EQ if I wanted. You guys get real mad about me flip-flopping on my pronunciation of his name, I've noticed. The comments are just... It's a war down there. I think I can see if WMC finishes a side training. But I can just take Hunter instead. I need to level up Hunter all the same, so... I'm gonna go ahead and pick a squad here for this light. You're gonna wait, and we're gonna have fun like we always do. Thank you. Alright, so you got Kit. Basically, the idea of the urban close quarters is there's a lot of distractible cover. You go in hard. You go in with people who can take hits. Dolly's perfect for the job of extra conditioning. You throw a bunch of... You blow up a bunch of cover, hence bringing an extra rocket instead of an extra shredder on Organ. And once you've blown up all the cover, you kill everything. That's... I'm sorry, I'm trying to make it sound more complex than it really is. It's quite simple. We go in, we smash everything, we kill whatever is left standing. Van Dorn's here to provide some longer range fire support from the rear, clean up, and also because he needs to level. Squint's here as well. Squint's kind of taking up the slack of the assault that isn't on this mission because the Marauder's here with Wolfer instead. I picked up resilience in the end for Squint after all my postulating the last time. Look, if I was going for pure damage, you know, VPT is obviously a much better choice, but like I said, I rarely go for pure damage builds on most classes because I don't really like glass cannons. And the idea here is that at least with resilience, I can use lightning reflexes on Squint without worrying that she's about to be crit, you know, out the ass by any number of the enemies that get opportunist in the late game. So this is going to allow me to use lightning reflexes actually a lot more commonly, I think, which is a really good thing. And apart from that, she's, you know, we're losing 2 damage, but she's still going to be more than effective enough as a hit and runner, or I'm probably not going to make her into an in-the-zoner, but as a hit and runner, she's going to operate just fine. And she can combo with the mechs that way as well if I take her on a mission with Daichi and Wolfer as well. Hunters bring in battle scans instead of extra kits. We've got Squints to handle Overwatch with the lightning reflexes. So instead of bringing extra medkits to heal up the mech after it's faced tanks the Overwatch, I'm bringing scanners on Hunter because on urban close quarters, I feel like the maps are small enough that... I feel like the smaller the map, the better battle scanners are. You go on one of those large UFO wood forest maps, this is a great way to illustrate it. You know, you go on like the biggest forest maps and it's like, I brought three battle scanners. Oh boy, this is great. You know, it's not going to tell you shit out of the actual percentage of the map. If you go on an urban close quarters and these are tiny maps, if you bring three battle scanners, you could pretty much cover like most of the map. You know, you've got wall hacks. So I feel like the less ground there is to cover, the more reason to bring battle scanners. And in this case, you know, the stars aligned and it made sense to bring them. Game, which is coming along with Snapshot. She's perfect for the job of urban close quarters map with Snapshot. And apart from that, yeah, it's the first hurrah of the Mech 2. Wolf is going to test drive this Mech 2 suit for us, even though he's probably the most junior of all my mech pilots. He did really well with the flamethrower, and he's what makes sense for this mission because it's a light. You know, these are the missions where I want to take Wolf. I want to train him up, get him to absorption fields on these lighter missions, and, you know, they don't come along that often, so we're going to do it while we can. So we're packing 4 lots of flamethrower, and we're going to get out there, and we're going to have a good old time. That's the operation. Let's get out there. Let's do it.
We have visual on the mission site. Setting down.
The drop site for this operation will be in Canada. Local government forces have reported a coordinated alien attack in a densely populated neighborhood. They're counting on us to secure the area.
This is fast food, and this is the hallmark urban close quarters map, I feel. When I designed, when I was theory crafting playstyles for each map type, which I did a while back, you can see down in the description, my squad loadout sheets for Beta 15, I'd often pick one map to think of mainly when designing the squad as a thought, you know, exercise, and definitely for urban close quarters, fast food is the one I think of. It really epitomizes it, however you pronounce that word, it really sums up everything I feel about urban close quarters, but you know what, let's leave that till next time, and let's end it right here. So join me next time for Operation Purple King, and until then, have a good one.